Hi, my name is Paul Walters, and one of the things that I do is wardrobe consultation and style advising. This video is posted in response to another video that I've seen on YouTube here that basically states that a button-down collar, such as what I'm wearing, should not ever be worn with a necktie. I wanted to take issue with that because, button-down collars with a necktie have been a mainstay of Ivy League and prep style for many years. It's mentioned briefly in the history of the button-down collar shirt in the other video that originally polo players, their collars would flap about in the wind as they played polo, and the buttons were added to those shirts to keep that from happening, and therefore it was a sports shirt and you should never wear it with a tie. Prior to the buttons being fastened on these polo player shirts, polo was played in dress clothing. They wear a traditional white dress shirt, sometimes even with a tie. The buttons were added to keep that from happening. But now polo players use what's really referred to as a tennis shirt when they play, that don't have collars on the necks at all. Collars on the buttons on the collar, excuse me. So it would be somewhat out of place to say that that's the only thing that those buttons are there for. Let's take a look throughout history at some style heavyweights who have been fucking things up for years by wearing ties with button-down shirts. Let's take a look. Knew that people like Miles Davis and Cary Grant and Jimmy Stewart and some of the other ones you saw in there, Gianni Agnelli, who else was there? Paul Newman, Malcolm X. There's a lot of people who are looking very dapper wearing button-down collar shirts with a tie. Now, it is the least formal of the collar types because it was used as a sports shirt. So, job interview, boardroom meeting, probably would not wear a button-down collar shirt, but certainly to the office, and even with the suit, it looks fine. Double-breasted suits are considered the most formal of the types of suits. So with a double-breasted suit, you would not wear a button-down collar. There's other things that have been designed for men on horseback that still are mainstays today. A single vented jacket, for example, was designed to fit over the horse's arse. Or the back of a saddle, hacket pockets with the button flaps that are becoming more and more popular in today's military style clothing that you're seeing on the market now. A lot of these things were designed for people riding horses, but they have found their way into very high-end menswear, probably even some suits produced by my colleague who I would consider myself friends with, who had done that video kind of speaking against wearing a tie with your button-down collar shirt. So anyway, those are things to keep in mind. It is okay to wear a tie with a button-down collar shirt. You just wouldn't want to do it with a double-breasted suit. And you would have to keep in mind that it would be considered the least formal of the dress shirts. However, it is still a dress shirt. It's still very viable. And if you look throughout pictures of Ivy League and prep school attire, the button-down collars are very, very popular there. In fact, New England clothing brands, J. Press, and then you have your Brooks Brothers as well, still keep button-down collar dress shirts, and some very nice dress shirts in stock all the time, and sell them with ties and suits day by day. So another thing that was mentioned in the video was how if you have a button-down collar, you have a kind of a roll to the collar, and that looks not polished, or I forget the term used. But the collar roll in a button-down collar shirt is actually something that people look for. Originally, you wanted a two-finger roll in a button-down collar. You had that roll to it. That was one of the things that people considered to be marks of a high-end button-down dress shirt. One that laid flat and buttoned down was considered poorly made. Now, this one here is from Brooks Brothers. This jacket that I'm wearing is Brooks Brothers as well. Sport coat with odd trousers, perfect place for a tie and a button-down collar. Even some nicer suits, but you'd want it to be a single-breasted suit, two-button, three-button suit. Even a one-button suit, you might consider, but a one-button suit is typically a more formal suit, like you'd see in a tuxedo. And you probably abstain from wearing a button-down collar shirt with a tie with a one-button suit as well. But anyway, my name is Paul Walters. I hope you enjoyed this video. And to the other fella who did a video, love you, man. I'm not trying to at all make you sound like you don't know what you're talking about, but I did want to shed a little bit of light on the button-down collar and the tie. It is, for many people, the trad style of dressing nowadays, or the preppy style. Ivy League style is very popular in some circles, not in all of them. But if your personal style rule is that you wouldn't get caught dead in a button-down collar shirt with a tie, by all means, don't do it. Some people don't like straight point collars. They want a Windsor spread collar in their shirt. Some people would never tie a four-in-hand knot like this is, to save their life. They want a Windsor knot all the time. And vice versa. James Bond said that people in Windsor knots looked like a cad, and he always wore the four-in-hand. So these are things to keep in mind. I appreciate you tuning in.